Hello, my brothers and sisters on the dragon's path. My name is Tim Heyer and I believe in dragons and Merry Christmas. Why should I say that? Why should I say Merry Christmas at all? Because what do we have to do with Christian holiday? Actually, a lot more than I thought. Because, you know, when events happen, most of the time it's this time of year. From November till February, the gates are very much opened. Because it's winter time, and winter time, the guardians of the gates will be opening their gates much more than in other times of year. And it's not really a Christian holiday, because it's actually an invented holiday for themselves. It was originally a pagan holiday, which has a lot to do with the dragon, because this is the darkest moments of the year, the darkest nights, and we return to the light. It cannot be only light or darkness. It always has to be a perfect balance. And that is where the dragon stands for. A perfect balance. But it's not only that. When I had visits, I can say, from dragon gods and guardians, most of the time they are very, very strong in this time of year. Very, very strong. And most of the lessons that I had, lessons that changed me and things like that, it was always in this time of year. The first Christmas with my dragon in 2005, I hardly remember anything. It was the most magical Christmas, and yet I hardly remember anything, just because the dragon was close by and the dragon was everywhere, and the dragon was showing me their realms, and that was what it made the most perfect Christmas of all. But it was not only then. It was all, every time that Christmas was approaching, I had more visions and dreams about dragons. And it was also when Tiamat, my dragon goddess, came to visit me for the first time in this time of year. But when Tiamat, also on Christmas moments, showed me the ways of her, of the dragon goddess of the earth, and that she was still here, that she still watching over her children, was also very magical. And I remember that she said that I needed to change and to see through the eyes of her children, and that I had to open them, open my eyes into this world, even though it can be hard. She will always stand by the side of her children, and also your dragon guardian. And I also remember years ago, it was also on Christmas, that I also remember that Leviathan, the dragon god of the void and waters, also came to visit me twice. But that was not to show me the dragon dimension, but also the dragon hell, which means the void. And the dragon god Leviathan wanted to show me the void, the place between spaces, on Christmas moments. It was, I believe, also on a winter solstice. And I could just know that Tiamat didn't want that, but Leviathan said, "Your eyes are not opened enough. I want you to see it all. I want you to see it everywhere." That is what I could remember from him. And I needed to see through his eyes. And I needed to see and feel everything that a dragon could feel. Even though I'm a human being, I could not handle it. I said many, many times, "I cannot handle this." And the dragon, the Leviathan, always continued on Christmas. And I remember a lot of dead animals and dead dragons that I could see in the void, still being alive, but also dead, screaming in pain, in fear. These emotions, my brothers and sisters, I cannot describe. But it turned out that I opened my eyes much more after it, that I could see to this world, this human world, with dragon eyes. And I didn't want that, but I needed to open up my dragon spirit much more than before. I became a vegan out of this. Of course, if you can see what humans do to this world, it's just horrible. It's horrendous. It's not something that you want to see in the when people everywhere are just eating so many darn horrible. Yeah. So yeah, I want to continue. But it's much more than that. It's much more than this. I needed to become a more dragon spirit that I didn't do enough. That actually, that Leviathan was pointing his finger to Tiamat, that she was not doing enough to awaken my dragon soul. And that he was interfering into my dragon's path. And that he also played a huge role into my path. And this huge role was very dark, but it turned out for me to open up my eyes much more. The dragon eyes. Of course, the dragon eye hurts. It hurts a lot, especially in the beginning, when you came to understand that you are actually the odd ones out much more than before. It already started when you were a child, that you were the odd ones out, that you just were different than the other children, that you already could see through the eyes of the dragon. But the dragon was still sleeping within you. It was not fully awakened yet. But you could somewhere feel the dragon nearby. And this feeling, my brothers and sisters, only grow when your dragon guardian found a way into you. And they opened your dragon spirit. And it was time to wake up. And then you could see much more through the eyes of the dragon. If you want it or not, it's who you are and who you are born to be. Of course, I'm not saying that everyone is going to be a vegan on the dragon's path. Of course not. It's an addiction. It's something that humans do. And I must say that I miss it sometimes. But I can feel the spirits. I can see through the eyes of animals. That is why also animals might do strange stuff. When they can feel your dragon spirit within. And they can see your dragon spirits around you. Dancing around you. Especially... that they can see the dragon around you, and that you can also have a moment that you can see through their eyes and see through their fears and happiness. That is actually not only humans, but also other animals than humans in this world that you can make contact to, and that you can see through their eyes and their souls. So yeah, Christmas time, that was my moment actually to be around with the dragon gods and the dragon guardians. I normally go to my forest and do rituals for them, and I wanted to be with Tiamat. I'm not that fond to Leviathan, of course, but because Leviathan always showed me this dark stuff. But it was actually to fight for the light. He was taking care that I was going to fight for the light, because dragons are light workers. And I wasn't a light worker enough for Leviathan. You can see how much darkness he is. But it's his darkness that turns us into the light. That he's shoving us into the light. He's actually the most perfect light worker of them all. And Tiamat, as a loving mother as she is, she didn't want me, my mind, to be destroyed. She was afraid that I would just close down. But Leviathan knew more. He knew that you can handle it. You can handle hell. You can handle the darkness. You have to see it all. And you know that other people never saw that. They don't have the dragon's eyes. And sometimes it hurts how much they destroy and how much they do so many horrible and bad stuff. They say peace on earth on Christmas and all this Christian stuff. But in fact, in reality, it's something totally different. We turn into the light, just like Leviathan is doing with us. He is showing us the darkness that is now coming and is now present. And in this darkness that we are growing ourselves, and our dragon soul is even more growing and more in this time of year, when Leviathan and Tiamat or the other dragon gods, Q and Fafnir and Pangu, that they are communicating with us to show us the ways of the dragon, to show us the ways that they live, to show us what it is to live among humans and watching with dragon eyes. Being one with the dragon, being one with everything, being one with nature, and being one with the gods. That is what Christmas is all about. Even though it's called Christmas, actually it's winter solstice, the longest night of the year, darkness that we turn into the light. And he showed me how to turn into the light and to fight for the light like a dragon does. The powers of the darkness to show us the balance that there has to be. Balance in dark and light. So, happy holidays, my brothers and sisters, and be blessed.